Hi, Tango Dancer. Do you want to make sure that you have your Tango foundations right?
Would you like to have two ways to do the cross?
In this video, we are going to show you two ways to do the cross and you will see whether you are a beginner or an advanced dancer. We are going to share with you some little technique tips that are going to make all the difference in how comfortable and creative you feel when you are dancing.
Hi, this is Pablo and I'm from Tango Space,
where we help men and women to move better, express themselves, become more creative and more elegant with our Tango lessons.
The cross is one of the basic and most important steps in Tango because it's something that is part of the walk, something that we use all the time. That's why we are going to look at two possibilities, two different ways to do the cross.
And in this video, we really go back into the foundations and help you really refine your technique for a beautiful and comfortable Tango cross. If you want to go deeper and have more variations, we have a free guide for you. And in it, we are teaching you three other ways to do the cross. So three ways to play with it so that you can guide them and use them more when you are dancing socially. We are going to put the link in the comments below. Make sure you click on the guide and join us there as well. So we are going to look at the cross in parallel and in cross system. We are going to break it down for you. Before that, we're going to show you what both movements, both variations look like with some Tango music. Now, let's look at the cross in parallel system. We are going to do this in practice embrace to show you the movements first.
So we begin with the apertura, with the side step. And here I'm going to take this a side step a bit longer. As always for the leader, it's a bit longer step, so I keep my partner on my right side. And then I'm going to step outside with my right leg. Yes? One, two steps. And now from here, I'm going to invite her to cross. Yes? So With the center of my chest, I'm going to bring her in front of me again. I change her weight, I change my weight, we collect, and then we go back. So, one more time. So here, side step, dissociation. Yes, here my center is moving to the side, okay? So I will do these two steps with intention on my right side, here with the center. So one, two, and now when I bring my center back in front, is what I'm going to invite her to cross. So torso, hips, leg, and then she cross. Collect, and then we resolve with a back step for the followers.
So for the ladies, there are a couple of elements at play and you really want to be very precise with your body here. So we're going to take a side step together. He takes a slightly bigger step and he dissociates. In Tango, we are always in a mirror, so we dissociate as well. Dissociating means that the upper body moves, but the lower body doesn't move. So here my torso faces him. You see I am diagonal in this direction. And then I'm going to keep walking, but I'm going to walk in the same direction that I was before. So my torso is in this direction, my hips and my legs are in this direction, here. I stay dissociated and I am very precise. This is where a lot of the ladies lose precision and don't step really behind themselves, which is the reason why this doesn't work, yes? And here I stay dissociated until I go back here and I follow his torso, he goes back straight in front and I do the same. He invites me to change my weight, I change my weight, I wait for him to change my weight, and then I am cross, collect, and go.
Now we show you with embrace. So we start in close embrace, apertura. One, two, and here I'm going to give the time and space for her to cross. Yes? So I'm going to send her in front, give the space and the time. Do you see leaders that I'm leaving my right leg behind? Yes. So I give that space for her to cross. I change her weight, and then we resolve with the back step. One common mistake that we see that leaders do is to try to lead the cross with the arm. Yes? So be careful with that. It's very subtle. Yes? It's very precise and it's from the center of the body. We are not using the arms at all. Yes? The arms is just to keep them braced, but we are not using the arms to lead. So when I begin the dissociation, I change the position of the center of my chest. And then I walk outside one, two steps, and now I do this circular movement from the center of my chest to invite her to cross in front. So it's this intention circular that will create the space for her to the cross, and it's the way that she will understand that you want to cross.
And we really want to emphasize this. We know a lot of dancers who have learned the cross in their beginner lessons use the left hand as leaders to cross, and this feels uncomfortable for your follower, for your partner. So really understand, and you want to really practice this. We know it is subtle, the movement and the fact that I am crossing my leg comes from the little circle that Pablo is doing with the center of his chest, not at all with the hand. So we show you again in the closing embrace. You see, our hand stayed in between both shoulders and did not move. Now, we show you another fundamental way to do the cross that is a little bit more sophisticated. It is with what we call the cross system. So cross system is another way to dance. It's another tool that we have in the tango dancing.
Yes. So the difference that we are going to do now, the difference with the cross and parallel system is that instead of changing the weight when she's in the cross, we the leaders, we are going to change the weight from the side step. Yes? After the side step, after the apertura, I'm going to change my weight and I'm not changing her weight. Yes? So I keep her weight in her right leg. And then we are going to go together with the left leg. Yes? So I step still outside, the same as the other one, but instead of going with my right leg, I go with my left leg. So we go one, two, and cross. So here I don't need to change my weight, so from here I change her weight and we go together straight away into the back step. So the idea of the leading is exactly the same. Yes, it's from the center of my chest, and I'm really dissociating. It's all the same. The only difference is that I go with the other leg. I go with my left leg, one, two, and when I bring my center forward, I invite her to cross. I change her weight, and then we go straight away into the back step.
For the followers, the steps are similar, and again, you want to be very precise. Don't forget that he is leading every part of the cross. You do not cross automatically. You wait for him to lead every movement of the cross. So here we take a side step with him. He's going to change his weight, so here, it's going to be very subtle. You're going to feel that you have just a little bit less space, but it's completely normal. Don't panic, dissociate more. Really bring your torso towards him to create some space when you are in the closing brace. And at the same time, you stay very precise so your hips stay in the line of dance. Here, that direction. Yes. Back step. Back step. And then here, he is going to make you cross with the center of his chest, remember? And then he is going to make you change your weight. So don't go automatically here. You bring your leg here, you wait for him to bring you to your left leg. You can cross the way you want. You can cross like this. You can add a little circle in on the floor if you want. And then we move forward together.
Now we'll show you in the close embrace. So, apertura, I change my weight. I don't change her weight. And then here I step outside, one, two, cross, and then continue.
Ladies, you really always want to keep the contact here. So your job is to only move as much as him so that you're not disconnecting. You stay really connected chest to chest from him.
Now we are going to show you how to dance both to tango music. And what we want to invite you to do with common tango movements like these ones or even more sophisticated movements is to really think not on the what, the steps that you are doing, but on the how. Look here how we are really adapting the speed, the quality, the physicality depending on the music. And this is really what is going to give another quality to your dancing. We really want to see you expressing yourself on the dance floor even with the most fundamental, the most common tango movements. There you have it, two ways, two fundamental ways to add the tango cross to your dancing. If you want to go deeper, if you want to have other variations of this very common tango movement, we have a special free guide for you with three variations on how to do the cross, how to guide it, how to follow it, so that you can include it into your social dancing. We'll put the link in the comments, make sure you click on the link, download the guide and see us there.
Yes, and remember how important is the cross. Yes, we always encourage tango dancers, you know, to keep it simple, the dance, and this is one of the simple moments that you want to really feel confident and to do in an organic way, in a way that it feels good for you and for your partner.
So we have a question for you now. Which of these movements are you going to start adding more of into your dancing? Is it number one, so the cross in parallel system? Is it number two, the cross in cross system? Please add it, tell us in the comments. We are always very curious about how you dance and we love to hear from you.
If you like this video, please like it and share it with your friends.
If you're on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell. That way you are going to be notified every time we release a new video and you are going to know all of our tricks and all of the secrets that we are sharing with you. And especially,
please keep learning and keep sharing your dancing because the world of tango needs your embrace.
Yes, definitely. Thank you so much for watching and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye!
Bye!